Hello everyone, I am Dr. Raman, medical oncologist working in Medicover Hospitals in Indore. Today I will discuss about oral cavity cancer. So oral cavity anatomically starts with lip and extends up to the posterior junction of anterior two-thirds to posterior one-third of tongue. It consists of lips, buccal mucosa, upper and lower alveoli, tongue, floor of the mouth and roof of the mouth that is constituted by the hard palate. So this is a complex structure, has a varied functions. This cancer arising from any of these structures constitutes oral cavity cancer, that's oral cancer. So why is it important to know about oral cancer? What are the risk factors of oral cavity cancer and how can we identify them? How can anyone prevent it? These are the aspects that I'm going to discuss. So first I will discuss why is it important to know about oral cavity cancer. So why should anyone know about oral cancer at all? So oral cavity cancer predominantly is seen in Southeast Asian countries. That is, Southeast Asian countries account for two-thirds of global burden. So among Southeast Asian countries, 50% of the global burden is from India. That is roughly around one-third of global burden is from India. So in India, roughly around 1 lakh cases of oral cavity cancer are diagnosed every year. And out of that, 80% of the patients die because of this disease. So it is important to know that everyone should be aware about disease, this deadly disease. So coming to the risk factors, we all know that it is a preventable cancer. It is a cancer arising because of the lifestyle changes. So major risk factors for this oral cavity cancer development is the tobacco usage. Tobacco usage in the form of either smoking or in the form of smokeless tobacco. So it is important culprit. It is known that patients who use tobacco are at a 10 times higher risk for development of oral cavity cancer. So tobacco has several ingredients, either in the form of smoking or smokeless tobacco. They have several harmful chemicals which leads anyone to develop this cancer. The problem in India is tobacco products are available at a cheaper price and they are readily available to anyone. So this is the reason why because of the prevalent tobacco usage in the society, majority of the cases in India are because of the prevalence, easy availability of tobacco-related products. Not only that, the people who are illiterate and low socioeconomic status, they are more of not aware of the side effects or the risk involved in usage of these drugs, these tobacco products. That results in development of oral cavity cancer. So one and foremost reason for the development of oral cavity cancer is the tobacco. Second reason for the oral cavity cancer is the alcohol. Excessive usage, consumption of alcohol is also a culprit. It is known that those people who habit of tobacco consumption and alcohol are at a higher risk of development of oral cavity cancer than those of the people who don't have these two habits. Those people who have a combination of tobacco consumption and alcohol consumption, they are 30 times risk than those people who don't have these habits. So tobacco and alcohol are the main culprits for the development of oral cavity cancer. So just because people are not aware of these two risk factors, that is the reason why India is having such a large burden of oral cavity cancer. Apart from these two risk factors, other less common risk factors for the development of oral cavity cancers are sharp teeth, that is because of the poor dentature, poorly fitting dentatures. This results in long chronic irritation and that will lead to a development of oral cavity cancer. Apart from that, these days we are seeing an increase in the oral cavity cancer, that is oropharyngeal cancer, due to HPV infection. So in infection with HPV is also a causative for the oropharyngeal cancer. So this can be prevented with HPV vaccination. So these are the routinely proposed risk factors for the oral cavity cancer. Apart from that, poor dental hygiene, lack of nutritional supplements in the form of vitamins, which will lead to the development of oral cavity cancer. So these are the reasons behind the development of oral cavity cancer. Especially in certain parts of Andhra, where people smoke by keeping the reverse end of the cigarette inside, that actually resulting in the very rare cancer what is seen, which is not seen regularly, is the heart palate cancer. If people has the habit of smoking with the burning end inside the mouth, because of that irritation, patients tend to develop this heart palate cancer. So these are the risk factors for oral cavity cancer. So if anyone has these risk factors, how can anyone identify that they are having a cancer? What are the symptoms which can tell someone that they are prone for the oral cavity cancer development? We'll look at the symptoms now. So any patient, any person who has a ulcer or a growth inside the cavity, which is persistent over the period of 2 or more weeks, then they should be worried about these symptoms. So they should consult a dentist or an ENT surgeon or an oncologist to have a look at it. And if needed, they should undergo biopsy to see what it is. So the first and foremost important symptom is the non-healing ulcer or any growth in the oral cavity, which may be associated with pain or may not be associated with pain. So this is the most common presentation. Apart from that, some of the patients do present with white patches in the mouth or red color patches in the mouth, which are hard to remove, which are not easily removable. So these are called as leukoplakia and erythroplakia respectively. These are the warning signs that because of these risk factors, oral cavity is giving you a warning that at least stop doing this from now onwards, so that I can subside. So if we don't act at that point of time, then the likelihood that these patients tend to develop oral cavity cancer in future. So regularly examine the mouth to look for these symptoms, that is non-healing ulcer or growth in the oral cavity, or any changes in the mucosa in the form of white patches or red patches or combination of both. Some of the patients present with trismus, that is difficulty in opening the mouth. They will have a pain while opening the mouth. This is called as trismus. The trismus indicates that the disease has grown to a larger extent. So anyone has a trismus. Trismus can be treated by a doctor if it is persistent over 2 weeks. So any pain while opening the mouth or difficulty in opening the mouth should alert anyone to seek medical advice. Some of the patients do present with loss of teeth. Without any trauma, some of the patients tend to lose their teeth. Even without infections, some patients lose teeth because of the growth in the oral cavity. So bone get destroyed with the tumor, that leads to the painless loss of tooth. So if anyone notices that, that should alert that there is something wrong with the oral cavity, and they should consult a doctor. So these are the risk factors and the symptoms of oral cavity cancer. So how can anyone prevent developing oral cavity cancer? As I told previously, we know that it is a largely preventable cancer. It occurs just because of our lifestyle changes. If we do the lifestyle modification, avoid these risk factors, then anyone can prevent the oral cavity cancer. So stay away from tobacco-related products and alcohol, and regularly examine the oral cavity. So I urge everyone who is looking into the video to spread this information and make the people aware about the risk factors and join the fight against the oral cavity cancer. Thank you.